Did anyone else notice Nora was still... Yeah, there you go, cricketing. Yeah, you noticed. Gosh. Now, I'm not exactly sure why they would struggle to take the baby from a mother that was just, well, incredibly confused and had just been frozen.
Come on, come on, come on! Oh God!
I think that would have gone a lot smoother for all of them if they just let her calm down a bit first.
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back.
But now they've made a serious mistake. Well, I guess this is going to be a coffin now.
God. Why would Vault-Tec do this?
And why would they do this?
The only one left.
Hello? Anyone?
Why'd they do this?
Yep, we've got fingers. That's one of the joys of being anthropomorphic. Huh. So, okay. Yeah. Asphyxiation. It's... everyone's suffocated. They found the one flaw. You need to be unthawed at least once. Yeah. No, it's not in this one, but... in the next room of cryopods, there's some names here. So, Mr. Pietro, there we go. Cindy Coffran, Mrs. Whitfield, Mrs. Coffran, and the male counterparts as well. Just keep those names in the back of your mind. Lots of coffee cups around. We'll take one for the road. Yeah, it looks like we'll need some tools. Oh. I guess it's through the side door then. That's a big bug. Oh, good job we've got a big stick. Nothing of interest around here, so to the computer. Ooh. Come on, back. There we go. Confidential. Security eyes only. A violation VTP 01011. Vault 111. Is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. You can read the things on the door? Such graphics, I know. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from the assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offences. Security staff are authorised to use lethal force. Operations Protocol Manual. Resident Admittance. Of course I managed to put my chat overlay in the one place where it would get in the way. Upon activation, something from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with the admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to their designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. That sounds a bit harsh. Okay, security protocols. Security patrols are to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer, and of Vault Tech. Let's go to the correct, or the first. Screen. It's going to take me a little while getting used to how the screens bend slightly and don't line up with my mouse cursor. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension, and must not interrupt suspension. Independent research is encouraged and left to overseer discretion. Well, there we go. There's our reason why we seem to get released when we did. I guess everyone else died. Facility services and maintenance. Due to the nature of Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these roles is left to the overseer discretion. All clear and evacuation. All clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all clear notice. Upon receiving the all clear notice, Vault Tech personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. Mandatory. What was that? Mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault Tech, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstance may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period, unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault Tech. cause some problems. Security logs. October 23rd, 2077. God, it finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs. I don't get it. Egghead's tried to explain it to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment. For a better future or something, I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we were smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? Apparently not. Christmas. Christmas Underground. Got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff. Had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake that wasn't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. Just don't get them. They're hiding something. They hiding something from us? Another company secret only for higher-ups? Whatever, just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through. Then we can start rebuilding. March 14th, the following year. Only a few weeks left in the mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting stir-crazy. Some people are even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. You can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months, tops. The overseer keeps telling everyone to be patient, focus on work. It's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad's going on, I just know it. April. The main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staff is in security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. Last entry. No all clear from the vault. No all clear from the vault tech is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. Almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening up the vault. Never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office along with the rest of the science staff. Supposed to hand over any food, weapons and medicine we have by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. Things didn't go too well, did they? There's one of those big bugs. Another security baton. Guess it's fight time. And I took a hit right away. Brilliant.
Roaches? What the hell?
Another computer. Overseer memo. Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Okay. And it looks like top 10 thing here. I won't play around with that, but I'll take the cart just in case. Card. I may play the mini games at some point, but Not exactly interested in doing that right now. Doesn't look like there's too much going on around here. So there's definitely bugs in here. Yeah. Not going through there. Okay. That went better than expected.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
A skeleton. Oh, boy. So, yeah. One of the mods that I said I've got is immersive combat. One of the things that it definitely changes is the way you strafe. It's a little bit more clunky to sidestep now. So you have to be a little bit more mindful in the way you move around. It makes positioning a lot more... a lot more of a factor when you're getting into a fight. Yeah, I'll take the glasses. Why not?
Is this all that's left?
Just doing a little bit of investigation. So, assuming that this chair was, say, around here, he was sitting in it. He's gone flying in that direction. Bullet holes line up. I wonder if one of the security team was brought in here and sat down and he drew a gun on the... I'm presuming this was the overseer. Also, apparently, your head shrinks when you die. So, not sure what that's about.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Interesting little toy there. Let's see what's on this terminal. So, overseer instructions. Overseer eyes only, violation of VTP. Yep. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of... blah, blah, blah. We've been through that. Long-term monitoring handled remotely by Vault Tech technicians. Under no circumstances is the suspension to be disrupted. This includes the administration of life-saving measures. Your staff is also considered expendable. Insubordination or attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Lovely. Cryolator. I've dreamed of making a cryogenic freezing available in a portable on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's all a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Okay, so the overseer made a gun in his spare time. Based. I think this is pretty much the same as what we saw before. Yeah. Staff duties. Independent research is encouraged. No, that's that. We had that before. Okay. Ooh, normal. And 180 days. Overseer's log. Preparations. Final staff. Something. Is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled. Several from Concord as well. Vault-Tec supervisors came up with this. Came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could join them to see and see the promise of our future realised. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. At less notice than expected. But only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Resident admittance went smoothly, everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happen so fast for these people. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. It did seem a little weird. Systems malfunction, a strange issue today with pod C3, I think that is. As I say, the chat overlay from on my end is cutting off that top line for me a little bit. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. Realised almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out.
Death is only the beginning. And you just
reveals the mysteries of the universe. Not that you'd know.
I only hope that their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Here, who was that? Who was it? Oh, Soap Acorn. Hello. Right, supplies running low. Now, there's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. Radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. Just have to keep everything under control until the all clear. Mutiny. Oh dear, brain sort of getting fried with sleep deprivation. Well, that doesn't sound good, Soap. Should probably try and get that sleep. And things are going to get even more screwy when you see what's going on here. Anyway, mutiny. A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. Not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. And consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritising who deserves what little food we have left. Been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. So, it all went kind of wrong. Yeah, Okay, doors open. Oh, fantastic. Right. Let's have a quick look in the overseer's office. See if there's anything we can pick up. Reserved cigarette packet. Nah, we're not a smoker. Oh, there was one thing that I did mention, or didn't mention, for this. I am not going to be using drugs aside from ones that directly heal or help me survive the effects of radiation. Med-X, I'm going to use sparingly. Werfault's mostly just social experiments that go wrong. Well, they were all social experiments. They weren't all meant to go wrong. It's just that they happened to mostly go wrong. Whoa. Wow, I messed that up. So, yes and no. The thing is, Vault-Tec were... they didn't know what was going to happen. They just saw their opportunity to run these experiments and took it. And I knew there was another one there. I did. I've installed several pony mods. I found this is the best way I can enjoy this game. The way the this game's sort of feel deviated from the original games was a little bit too much for me to bear. So I've bonified the place just to push it even further so that my brain goes, okay, this is ridiculous, I'll enjoy the ridiculousness. So, yeah, I added a bunch of mods, and where possible, I also took the pony patches just to integrate them as well. Yeah, that was another odd thing about Vault-Tec. When they saw the opportunity for an experiment, they took it. And in more than one instance, that meant that they were performing an experiment on the people performing experiments as well.
Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out? Oh, God.
But we don't know any of that, really. Only what we've read so far. Ah, more ammo. Definitely use the ammo. Okay. Now, let's get out of here. But yeah, I think in this instance, there was a secondary experiment going on the scientists here, to see the effects of an enclosed space and with the promise of a release period that never actually comes. And to monitor the behaviour of the staff here, see what would happen. I can't remember if that is actually confirmed or not later on in the game, but I am fairly sure that's what happened here. Right, well, I don't need to change anything here. I think I'm good.